तो आवाज आ रही है? आर यू गेटिंग माई वॉइस? चेक ओके, आर यू वेटिंग? है ना? अरे अरे, ओके, ठीक है। तो दिस इज फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑन हेमेटोलॉजी। प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड हेमेटोपोएसिस, देन बिफोर हेमेटोपोएसिस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस बोन मैरो ट्रांसप्लांटेशन। सबसेक्वेंटली वी विल रिपीट दैट प्रेजेंटेशन। In previous lecture, we have discussed about the iron metabolism. Now, this is a very important topic for MBBS label. This is iron deficiency anemia, because iron deficiency anemia is a public health problem. This is in fact most common cause of anemia. It is responsible for up to 50% of anemia due to nutritional deficiency. And in developing countries like us in India, it is responsible up to 70% of the case. Okay, so today lecture we will go about this, discussing about the iron deficiency anemia. In the very first slide, we will discuss about how important iron deficiency anemia is. Then we will discuss about the causes in general, then causes of iron deficiency anemia. Then we will discuss about the clinical feature and investigation. After that, we will take up the stages of iron deficiency anemia. So it will be very easy to understand. And in the last, we'll discuss the treatment and different strategy for iron supplementation. Okay. Now, as I told earlier, iron deficiency anemia is a most prevalent form of malnutrition. Even it is more prevalent than protein energy malnutrition. And globally, this iron deficiency is responsible for around 50% of the all cases of anemia. And in developing countries, it may go up to the 70%. In India, though, if there are two options, dimorphic anemia is more common or iron deficiency anemia is more common, so we will go with the dimorphic anemia. Otherwise, iron deficiency anemia is most common form of anemia in our setup. Okay. Deficiency of any of the nutritional element, say it iron, say it calcium, say it vitamin D, anything, there is mismatch between supply and demand. If supply decreases or demand increases or losses increases, then there will be decrease in the that nutrient. Like in supply, there is two components. Either it is deficient in the dietary content itself, or it may be not absorbing from the gut. Okay, so supply can hamper in these two levels. Either it is deficient in food or it is malabsorbing, not absorbing from the gut. Otherwise, if demand of the body increases, there are some phases of life in which the demand of certain components goes up, like in growth, like in pregnancy, there is increased demand of nutrients. So it leads to the supply demand mismatch, and if there is a loss of nutrient more than the supply, then the pool will decrease. There would be three main headings where the causes can intervene, like in decreased supply, increase in demand, or increase in loss. Okay. So if supply decreases, iron pool will decrease, leads to the iron deficiency anemia. If the demand increases, we will look after the causes where the demand increases, then the pool of iron will decrease and leads to the iron deficiency anemia. And same with the increased losses. If the loss of iron or blood will increase, then it will lead to the iron deficiency anemia. Then what are the causes of decreased supply? As I told before, it may be decrease in the dietary content. Like if patient is taking inadequate diet, or it may malabsorb from the gut. Malabsorption may be due to the disease process, or it may be the surgical cause which leads to the malabsorption, like in tropical screw or Crohn disease. One most important thing you should remember, iron get absorbed from the proximal intestine, duodenum and duodenum mainly, proximal intestine. Any pathology which affect the proximal part of intestine will lead to the iron deficiency, otherwise there will be no effect on iron. If distal intestine is involved, then there is no effect on iron absorption. So any surgery which affect the any initial part of intestine, duodenum and jejunum, wo bhi proximal jejunum, like gastrectomy will cut the this stomach and proximal part, duodenum and proximal part of ileum, many of the cases. So the main absorption area of iron will reduce, so it will lead to the decreased absorption of the iron. Okay, in any acute or chronic inflammation condition, why there is iron absorption decreases in any form of systemic inflammatory disease, say it acute or chronic, comment in chat box why it is so that iron absorption decreases in chronic or acute inflammation. Okay, we will take it up after the lecture. Okay, the second part is, it may be increased losses or demand or loss will increase. Like when the demand of iron will increase, if a patient is growing very fast, infants and adolescent grows very fast, so the requirement of iron increases. Pregnancy is growth of fetus inside the mother womb, so the requirement of fetus is very high, so the iron is shunted towards the fetus, so there is increased demand of iron. And if you are giving erythropoietin, what happens? Erythropoietin stimulates the erythroid hyperplasia, and if the erythroid hyperplasia is there, the erythroid cells are rapidly dividing, the mobilization of iron takes place and demand will increase, and this will further lead to the deficiency if not properly supplemented. Okay, there may be the increased loss may be due to the acute blood loss or chronic blood loss. In acute blood loss, like trauma, if the hemorrhage occurs, the blood will loss, along with the blood iron will loss, because every 1 ml of packed RBC contains 1 mg of iron. With blood loss, iron will loss. In chronic blood loss, which is most common form of actually most common cause of anemia, it may be due to the some carcinoma, acid peptic disease. In our tropical countries, this is warm manifestation is very common, especially in children's, like hookworm infestation. Or in females, a special process is menstrual bleeding. In single menses, a female loses around 80 ml of blood. 80 ml of blood means a huge loss of iron. Or many a time, it cannot be supplemented with the oral iron, oral dietary iron. So these females subsequently develop the iron deficiency anemia. This may be the reason why iron deficiency anemia is far more common in female than male, because females are losing blood physiologically. Apart from the other causes which are common in male and female, like hookworm infestation, is female are not resistant to hookworm infestation. It can occur in them also. But additionally, they are losing blood by their a physiological process, menses. Okay, if someone is donating blood very frequently, blood donation is again a blood loss, maybe for noble cause, but it is a blood loss. So with repeated blood donation without proper supplementation can lead to iron deficiency anemia. Phlebotomy is a process in which we draw the blood from veins, like in polycythemia vera. It is a treatment, sort of treatment, but again we are losing the blood. If you are losing a blood anywhere, means you are losing the iron. So if it is repeated many time, it can lead to the iron deficiency anemia. Okay, to summarize, the causes of iron deficiency anemia may be due to the decreased supply, that is decrease in the oral content, oral dietary content are due to the malabsorption. Okay. Second, it may due to the increased demand in different stages, in different sort of subset of people, like one who is growing very fast, like in pregnancy, and in some cases, in fact, in majority of cases, it is due to the increased loss. Maybe most commonly in the chronic blood loss. Okay. So now we'll discuss this stages of iron deficiency anemia. It will be very hard to understand at this point of time when you are not aware of different iron parameters. So we will take up it after the investigation part. So I am skipping these two slides for sake of better understanding the stage of anemia. We'll look, there are three main stages of anemia. When iron deficiency, in fact, stages of iron deficiency. Normally what happens? If there is less iron supply, then there is stores already there in the body. If there is less supply, this store will deplete. But the parameters will remain normal. The store will rapidly deplete because all the iron parameters will remain normal. So we can call it the first stage, and there is a negative iron balance, but there is the iron inside the body which is sufficient for hematopoiesis. In second stage, which is also known as intermediate stage, there is an iron deficient erythropoiesis. Supply demand has been mismatched. There will be the manifestations in form of different iron profile will get deranged. In the last stage, when there is more and more deficiency of iron, it will lead to the iron deficiency anemia. This is the final. Finally, iron deficiency will lead to the anemia. That is third stage. But the features of these three stages we will discuss after the investigation part. This will discuss after the investigation part. Then, what are the clinical features of iron deficiency anemia? So any form of anemia, be it iron deficiency, be it B12 deficiency, be it hemoglobinopathy, hemolytic anemia, everywhere, there are something that is common to every form of anemia. Like in very first lecture, when we will discuss the basics of anemia, we have discussed certain feature of anemia, like anemia patient will develop easy fatigability, will develop loss of tolerance to exercise, C will develop loss of stamina. On examination, pallor will be present. Pallor may be, though anemia is most common cause of pallor, but pallor is not interchangeable with anemia, because there are certain causes where pallor is present, but there is no anemia. Okay? Then I ask you to write in the chat box after the lecture, not this time you will concentrate over the what I am saying. Okay, then write down this question: what are the causes of pallor without anemia? Okay, then there are certain features which are very specific to iron deficiency anemia, or it may be attributable to iron deficiency anemia, though maybe other causes, like chelosis, where the angular stomatitis is a form where iron, it is more common in iron deficiency anemia, though it may be also found in thiamine deficiency and other vitamin deficiency. Wilonychia is increased brittleness of the nails, and eventually it will lead to the spooning, spoon-like appearance of nail, as shown in this figure here in picture. This is spooning. It is a sign of severe intracellular iron deficiency. Okay. Then pica. Pica is a patient used to eat something which is having no established nutritional value. Like he may eat earth, he may eat sand, he may eat ice. Ice is known as pagophagia. Geo is for earth. मतलब वो and फिर वो चाप खा सकते हैं. There is one more thing associated with this iron deficiency anemia is restless leg syndrome. Though it is not exclusive to the iron deficiency anemia, but it is common in iron deficiency anemia. What happens in restless leg syndrome? Patient has propensity to move his leg. He cannot put his legs stand still. He used to be restless. So it is known as restless leg syndrome. Okay. As far as iron deficiency anemia is concerned, we must remember that in causes, especially in causes, this clinical feature, why it is important? Because when you are exploring the history, you should must consider this point that iron deficiency anemia in adult male or postmenopausal female. Because postmenopausal female, there is no menses, means there is no blood loss. Matlab, postmenopausal female are at advantage of premenopausal female as far as iron is concerned. So if in these two set of patients iron deficiency anemia develops, then you should must rule out GI loss of iron. So it is dictum that you should, there is a cause of GI blood loss until proven otherwise. Means the GI loss must be searched for. So if you are going to investigate this patient, this set of patient, we will remember that in these two subset of patient, we must subject them to evaluation for the GI blood loss. May be it upper or lower GI endoscopy or some sort of stool routine microscopy for ovariances. So this is must, especially in male and postmenopausal female. Okay. There are certain risk factors in which more propensity to develop iron deficiency anemia. There may be some demographic factors to play, like one who is elderly, as I said, teenagers are growing very fast. This will lead to the increased demand and finally iron deficiency. Some dietary factors, like one who is taking excessive tea contain tannins and vegetables contain phytates and phosphate sulfates. These used to bind the dietary iron, making it less and less available for absorption. Certain socio-demographic factors are there, like low socioeconomic status, poverty, overcrowding. These are all causes of increased propensity to infection, lead to the systemic inflammation and further hampers the iron absorption. Okay. Now, how we are going to investigate when we are suspecting the iron deficiency or any sort of anemia? Initially, we are not aware. We are aware like she is having some anemia. We are going to evaluate. Then this is thought to be a separate lecture regarding the red cell indices and decoding CBC. We will take later. But today we will discuss more which factors more relevant to the iron deficiency. There is something known as the red cell indices, in which the mean corpuscular volume. This cell you can replace, but original word is mean corpuscular volume, that is MCV. It is the average size of a single red cell. A single red cell, what is an average size? And this is represented in femtoliter. Femtoliter is a unit of it. And normal value of this is 8200. 8200 femtoliter. Second red cell indices is mean corpuscular hemoglobin, that is MCH. It is the average weight of hemoglobin in the RBC, average weight. Okay, it is expressed in picogram, and the normal value is 30 plus minus 3, means 27 to 33 picogram. Okay, MCHC, mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, it is an average concentration of hemoglobin inside RBC volume, matlab unit RBC volume, average concentration of hemoglobin. It is expressed at gram per deciliter. And it is usually, in percentage, it is usually 33 plus, matlab one third of, this is where the, when we will discuss now, this hemoglobin synthesis and metabolism, when we will discuss about the hemoglobinopathy, where we will learn that this is where the saturation reach. A cell cannot have more than 33% of its volume with hemoglobin, because where there occurs the saturation. There are only some conditions where the MCSC may raise above this value. And these conditions are right down in the chat. What are the conditions where MCSC values become above normal, above one third of the cell volume? Okay. In peripheral smear, and otherwise we'll order it in name of general blood picture, GBP, general blood picture. We see the different size of cell, the cell, and they will look smaller than the small lymphocyte. The small lymphocytes are of size of normal RBC. If the size decreases less than small lymphocyte, then it is microcytosis. What is the red cell indices indicating microcytosis is MCV. If fall below 80, it will called as microcytosis. Okay, and there are different shapes. If the different shapes are there in PBS, it will be called as poikilocytosis. If different size is there, it is called as anisocytosis. Then what we'll learn, anisocytosis is all about size of RBC and poikilocytosis is all about shape of RBC. Okay. In peripheral blood smear, if the size is less than small lymphocyte, it is microcytosis. If this central pallor is more than 1/3 of RBC, then it will be called as hypochromia. Normally 1/3 of central pallor comprises 1/3 of red blood cell, but it is goes beyond 1/3, more than 1/3, it will be called as hypochromia. Then microcytosis is less cell. How will come to know? It will be lesser than small lymphocyte, but hypochromia is pallor more than 1/3. What red cell indicate hypochromia is MCSC. MCH has no value in classification of anemia. Only the MCV and MCSC have. Okay, MCSC will decrease in hypochromia. Okay. Now, the most important section for evaluation of iron deficiency anemia is lab investigation to look after this iron. So, lab iron studies. The very first parameter is serum iron. Okay. Serum iron never stay free in blood because it is very toxic. It is very much oxidoreductive stress over the cell. So, it stays bind with transferrin. Transferrin is a carrier protein. Okay, so it remain bound to the transferrin. Okay, serum iron label, if you estimate, it will not give same result in every hour of day, because serum iron, almost many of the parameters, blood parameters, have some diurnal variation. If you measure iron in morning, it will give you a relatively higher value than when it is measured in evening. Means serum iron is a parameter which shows diurnal variation. Okay, the very second parameter is TIBC, that is total iron binding capacity. Okay, the iron bounds to transferrin. We can estimate transferrin directly, but we cannot. So we come up with a new parameter known as total iron binding capacity. It is a indirect measure of circulating transferrin. In iron metabolism, we have seen transferrin occurs in two places. First, inside the breast border epithelium and in circulation. So TIBC is a measure of circulating transferrin, not inside. And it is also logical because we are drawing blood. We are not scraping the breast border epithelium. Okay. The normal value for TIBC is 300 to 360. Okay. Okay. Put it like this. Serum iron normal value is 50 to 150. It will be hard to remember, but once you remember, you can just double this value. Serum iron normal value is 50, 150. 150, if you double it, you will get 300. And 300 is a value for TIBC. Normal value, agar single value, if you want to remember, you can remember 150 and 300, just double, because transferrin binds to how many iron? 2 iron. So double. If you link अदरवाइज मतलब इट विल बी वेरी हार्ड टू रिमेम्बर. जस्ट टू रिमेम्बर मैक्सिमम आयरन ट्रांसफरिंग कैन बाइंडेज टू. सो इफ यू आर लुकिंग फॉर टोटल आयरन बाइंडिंग कैपेसिटी देन यू कैन जस्ट डबल द आयरन वैल्यू. इट इज लॉजिकल जस्ट टू रिमेम्बर इट मे नॉट बी द कॉज. ओके सेकेंड इज ट्रांसफरिंग सेचुरेशन. यूजली इफ यू मीन दिस 50 एंड 150 द मीन विल बी 100. ओके and the serum iron any time circulating inside the body in normal condition is 100. okay the total iron binding capacity is 300 to 360 say is 300. then if you divide 100 by 300 you will get one third. okay again if you divide this 50 with 300 and 150 with 300 you will get this value of 50% and 25%. so iron saturation may vary from transferrin saturation may vary from 25% to 50%. okay if it is more than 50% means this transferrin may deliver this iron to the non hematopoietic cells means it may deliver to somewhere in cardio some myocardium or liver and it will lead to the iron overload there and ultimately dysfunction. okay and if it is less than 25 means lower limit se kam means 20% it will indicate the iron deficiency anemia. okay the next parameter is serum ferritin. okay where ferritin comes in iron metabolism it is a storage protein along with hemosiderin. hemosiderin also a sort of iron storage protein but mobilization of iron from serum ferritin is much more easier than hemosiderin. practically it is said that hemosiderin iron cannot be mobilized in normal condition. matlab it is a permanent storage of iron. okay serum ferritin is a storage form so it must correlate with the iron a total iron store of body. so serum ferritin correlates with the total iron store of body. okay see body iron can be looked by two methods. first is serum ferritin and second you can stain the reticular endothelium. you can stain the bone marrow. okay but it is very hard to stain bone marrow because it is an invasive procedure. so it is a proxy for iron storage. so serum ferritin is less then iron stores are depleted. if serum ferritin is high means iron this iron stores are repleted. okay normally the iron store of male is around 1000 milligrams. okay 1000 milligrams and in female it is 300. in fact the normal storage of female is 0 to 300 means a female can normally have no iron store. so if serum ferritin is in male it is expected to be on higher side than in female. in fact any iron parameter can be expected to on higher side in male than in female. so in a adult male serum ferritin is 100. okay so how to remember serum ferritin normal label it is mean value of serum iron. if you are able to remember this iron value 50 to 150 it is not very hard to remember 50 to 150 you can remember almost all the parameters. okay this mean value is 100 then serum ferritin will be 100 in male and female it will be 1 gram is this 1000 milligram is stored it correspond to 100 microgram per liter. if female is having 300 then it will correspond to 30 microgram per liter. it is not very hard to remember. okay if this serum ferritin level falls below 15 means the value which female have half of the value which female have means less than 15% there is no iron store inside the body. Okay, then in iron deficiency anemia, are we expecting there is iron store? No, we are not expecting there is iron store. So the serum ferritin level we are expecting to less than 15%. Is the less than 15 microgram per liter. Okay, next is bone marrow iron store. How we can assess it, estimate it? It can be estimated by sampling this bone marrow. We can do aspiration or we can have biopsy of that bone marrow. Then we will subject it to Prussian blue staining. Okay. But problem with this bone marrow biopsy is it is an invasive procedure. And we have a better guide, not better, but at least a comparable gauze is serum ferritin. So if you can estimate serum ferritin, why to go for this marrow for just to estimate iron store? It is not logical. So most of the cases it is supplanted by the serum ferritin. Okay, if you subject this to the bone marrow aspiration or biopsy, then you will see 20-40% of all erythroblasts contain iron, stainable iron, means iron in the cytoplasm, and this is normal. And these erythroblasts with the iron staining is known as sideroblast, because sideroblast, matlab sidero is also for iron, so sideroblast inside the iron. But in iron deficiency anemia, iron will not mobilize, so the cytoplasmic iron will decrease, so the erythroblast staining for iron will decrease, means the sideroblast will be very few or it will totally disappear in iron deficiency anemia. Something is known as myelodysplastic syndrome. We will discuss in subsequent lecture what is myelodysplastic syndrome. What happens in myelodysplastic syndrome? There occurs the mitochondrial dysfunction, which leads to the iron around the nucleus. So if you stain a cell, the iron will stain all around the nucleus, and it will appear like a ring. And this type of sideroblasts are known as ring sideroblast. For now, you can remember that ring sideroblast is the bone marrow feature of myelodysplastic syndrome. We'll discuss later when we are discussing this myelodysplastic syndrome. Okay. Now there is something known as protoporphyrin. In hemoglobinopathy, we will discuss about the synthesis and degradation of hemoglobin. So a normal hemoglobin is having heme part and globin part. It is synthesized separately. Heme part is synthesized, and one of the intermediate of heme synthesis is protoporphyrin. Okay. Suppose if heme synthesis is impaired, the final product of any pathway is impaired, is not forming, then body tends to form it more and more, because body require it for oxygen carrying. Okay, so what happens? The intermediate products will go up. Say if 1% is finally converting to the final product, if body increases normally 100, then one unit will form. If body is increased to the 300, at least 3 units will be formed. Matlab the value, the percentage will be same, the value will go up. So the protoporphyrin level will grow up if there is a problem with heme synthesis. And iron is an integral part of heme. If iron is deficient, this heme synthesis will hamper and protoporphyrin level will go up. So normally in body, the protoporphyrin level in RBC, we are estimating in red blood cell, inside the red blood cell, not in plasma. Okay. It will normally be less than 30 microgram per deciliter. But if it is 3 times of the normal value, where the mostly in medicine will look like 3 times of normal value, most of the places. So 3 times of normal. No? 3 times is 30, 3 times is 90. But more than 100 is in consensus with iron deficiency. Serum protoporphyrin level. Okay. Lead poisoning is one thing where also this heme synthesis is impaired, and this is the something basophilic stippling and microcytosis. It is very much differential of iron deficiency anemia. There also this protoporphyrin level will go up. Okay. Now, something is known as soluble transferrin receptor protein. Transferrin receptor protein means TRP. Okay. In heme metabolism, we look that this transferrin receptor are responsible for carrying up blood, this iron inside the effector cell, inside the erythroid cell. Okay. Suppose you want to carry something inside this room, okay? And there are three portals. There are three portals you can put at the gate. Okay, there are three this labels which can carry things from outside to the this room. Okay, and you are sitting in the corner of room. You are not aware of the situation outside the room. Okay, suppose you want at least three units of something outside to inside. Okay, and you are getting just one. This is in your control that you can order more number of people to go there and collect the things. Okay, means this man are transferrin receptor sitting inside the cell. If the cell deprive of the iron, it will cause this transferrin receptor to move over the surface. Means the transferrin receptor expression will go up. Okay, if there is less iron supply, means in iron deficiency anemia, this transferrin receptor will increase, and this is the propensity of this transferrin receptor to leak in the plasma. They will leak. Means more and more number of transferrin receptor expressed, more and more will be leaked inside the plasma. Means the soluble, and this is known as soluble transferrin receptor protein, will go up. If there is a deficiency of iron, expression of TR will increase, transferrin receptor will increase. Means the soluble transferrin receptor inside the plasma will increase. Okay, you got it, where this why this transferrin receptor is going up. Okay, second condition where this transferrin receptor protein can go up is if this number of rooms will increase. Say there is one transferrin receptor in a one room and there are 10 such rooms, then the total number will go 10 fold above. Okay, so if there is erythroid hyperplasia of any cause, this will lead to the increase in transferrin receptor, or if there is a decrease in the iron. Okay, so the normal value of soluble transferrin receptor is 4 to 9. For the sake we can remember 10. Yeah, no, 150 to 150, 100, 10. You can remember 10. 4 to 9 will be hard to remember. Then we will remember 10 because it will be approximate of the value. Okay. And this soluble transferrin receptor can be used to differentiate between the anemia of chronic disease and the iron deficiency anemia. In the separate lecture, when we look at iron, this anemia of chronic disease or anemia of inflammation, then we will look after these issues. Don't worry. Okay, the normal values you can remember, the serum iron normally it is 150 to 150. TIBC is just double, means 300. The transferrin situation is 25 to 50%. Serum ferritin is normally in adult male is 100 and female is 300, corresponds to the iron stores. Normal serum protoporphyrin level is less than 30 microgram per deciliter. Soluble transferrin receptor protein is 4 to 9 microgram per liter. Okay. Now, you must order some investigation which can make you more wise to rule out the cause of iron deficiency. Like in tropical countries, in otherwise, what dictum we have remembered? There is GI loss unless proved otherwise in two subset of patients, like adult male and postmenopausal female. So GI blood loss can be estimated by the upper or lower GI endoscopy, stool for occult blood, and stool microscopy for ovarian cysts. Apart from this, if the clinical features suggest, we can order this malabsorption syndrome, different profile for tropical screw and other things. And if there is any sign of inflammation and infection, then we can order accordingly. But in causes, we must remember, we must order the this stool for occult blood, OBA and cyst, and upper and lower GI endoscopy. This is must for each and every patient of iron deficiency anemia, especially in adult male patient and female who are most vulnerable. There are some differentials of microcytic hypochromic anemia. As discussed in the very basic lecture of iron deficiency anemia, it is SITAL. S for sideroblastic anemia, I for iron deficiency anemia, T for thalassemia, A for anemia of chronic disease or anemia of inflammation, and L for lead poisoning. Okay, what we are expecting? In iron deficiency, there is deficiency of iron, means the iron parameter will reduce, means serum iron will decrease, PIBC will increase, this percentage saturation of transferrin will decrease, ferritin level, which correspond to the store, will decrease, and hemoglobin will be normal on electrophoresis. Okay, but in thalassemia, though we will get this microcytic hypochromic picture, but serum iron, TIBC, percentage saturation, this all will be normal. Okay. Something to remember in anemia and inflammation, we will discuss again in next lecture. The serum iron will be less. The causes I have asked in very first slide, why there is a decreased absorption of iron in acute or chronic inflammation anywhere in the body. So the serum iron will be less than normal, but it will be less than, not less than 30. TIBC will less, but it will be approximately of near the lower normal limit. Percentage saturation will be lesser, but the serum ferritin will be high, because serum ferritin is also a acute phase reactant. It increases in all the inflammation. The serum ferritin will be increased. And this we have discussed. This can, and one thing we have discussed, na, ki soluble transferrin receptor protein can be used to differentiate between these two, because it will increase in the iron deficiency, but it will remain normal in the anemia of inflammation. Okay. And sideroblastic anemia, what happens? Sideroblastic means there is a high iron. So the percentage saturation will be more than 50%. Normally it is less than 10% in iron deficiency anemia, but it will be very high in this sideroblastic anemia. Okay. Then the ferritin, which is looking after the, which is the indicator of the stores, will be repleted, because there is excessive. So the serum ferritin will be normal or higher. Okay. And in thalassemia, if you do electrophoresis, it will show there is abnormality in globin chain. Okay. We will discuss when we are discussing hemoglobin. Okay. Now, there are three options available for treatment of iron deficiency anemia. The first, what you can do is, you can transfuse packed red blood cells. In short, it is known as PRBC, means you can transfuse red cells. You can supplement oral, and this supplementation can be done by oral route or can be parenteral. Okay. So in red blood cell, there are very limited number of indications. Like, patient is having very severe symptomatic anemia, but you will not forget to send investigation before transfusing the blood. Okay. Otherwise, you will land up in nowhere. The red cell indices and the hemoglobin, this iron parameters will fall in different categories. Different values fall in different categories. Okay. So don't forget to send investigation before transfusing. The indication are if patient is severely symptomatic with anemia, there is cardiovascular instability, there is incessant or continuous or excessive loss of blood. Okay, what is the importance of red cell transfusion? It will stabilize our patient. Apart from that, it will also supply the iron, because it is going to recycle inside the body, because there is no mechanism to excrete iron. Okay, as I told before, 1 ml of packed cell contain around 1 mg of elemental iron. Okay, and if you are transfusing packed red blood cell, each unit of packed cell is expected to increase hemoglobin by 1 gram per deciliter. Okay, second option with us is oral iron therapy. Oral iron therapy is a preferred route of iron supplementation unless contraindicated or not tolerated, or there are acute need. We will discuss in parenteral. Okay, the usual dose of iron is 200 milligram of elemental iron per day. Okay, this iron should be given preferably at single dose, and preferably to be taken at empty stomach, because the food will decrease the bioavailability. But problem with empty stomach is it will cause more and more gastric irritation, and this gastric irritation, gastric intolerance, is a cause of non-compliance to the iron therapy. Okay, what duration do you require to treat? You will require to treat this iron deficiency till 6 to 12 months farther from the iron level become normal. Okay, to replenish the stores. Okay, what you expect if you are giving iron deficiency, if you are replacing the iron, the very first thing patient will notice is clinical improvement. Patient start regaining his appetite, her appetite. Some patient may be having history of pica or pagophagia. This is the very first thing to improve. In the biochemical parameters, reticulocyte count will be very first to increase. The reticulocyte count will increase on the 4th to 7th, yani first week of treatment, and it will reach its maximum in 1.5 weeks. The iron is expected to rise after 2 weeks, and the maximum effect will be on 6 to 8 weeks. In 6 to 8 weeks, we will expecting that the hemoglobin will rise. The hemoglobin start rising after 2 weeks. Okay. And if iron supplementation is adequate, we will expect at least 1 to 2 gram iron increase per week. Okay. Okay. If there is no response, you are giving iron and there is no response, then you should inquire about the compliance or absorption. Compliance, you can ask the patient, but it is depends upon the patient. You want to tell or not. Okay. Then there is something you can do is iron tolerance test. In iron tolerance test, what you do, you take 2 tablets of the iron, give to the patient empty stomach, then estimate the iron subsequently for 2 to 3 hours. There should be at least 100 microgram increase in the serum iron. Okay, then means the absorption is okay. Okay, there are side effects of oral iron therapy. Most of the cases it is GI intolerance. Means patient can develop abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, and constipation. In iron therapy, constipation is far more common than diarrhea. In fact, constipation is quite common. Diarrhea is quite rare. There are few oral preparation available with us, like ferrous sulfate, ferrous fumarate, ferrous gluconate and polysaccharide iron. Polysaccharide iron is 100% iron. Means 150, this contain 150 mg of tablet, contain 150 mg of iron. While ferrous sulfate in 325, it contains 65 mg of elemental iron. Ferrous sulfate is 325 mg of tablet, contain 107 mg of iron. And while ferrous gluconate contain 39 mg of iron. Okay. The major problem with this iron therapy is GI intolerance. There are something we can do for in improving tolerance. So tell me what you can do regarding increasing the tolerance, means decreasing the side effect of iron therapy, question number one. Question number two, what are the strategies to increase the bioavailability of iron? Because when you are giving 200 milligram of elemental iron, not more than 50 milligram is going to absorb. And that as soon as this anemia start correcting, this absorption will decrease less and less. Okay. Initially, it may be 50 milligram, 250 milligram may be absorbed. But in later stages, when hemoglobin comes to the normal, maybe just 1 milligram of the total dose is absorbed. Why it is so and what you can do to improve bioavailability of the iron? There is two questions. First, what you can do to increase tolerance? And what you can do to increase bioavailability? Tell me after the class. Okay. Second option is parenteral iron therapy. In this parenteral iron therapy, there are very limited indications. Very important this intolerance to the oral iron is one. One should go to the parenteral therapy. Then in GI diseases, there is really no absorption. So we have to go for parenteral therapy, and if the need is acute, okay? If there is ongoing blood loss, so each packed cell 1 milligram of iron will lose. So it will not cope up with oral iron, so you have to. And in erythropoietin therapy, this demand of iron is very high, so it cannot be fulfilled with the oral therapy. There are few preparations are available. In previously, there is high molecular weight dextran is available, but side effect was very high. The risk of anaphylaxis was very high with this. In recent days, this newer preparation has developed, like ferumoxytol. In single injection, it will deliver 510 milligram. Sodium ferric gluconate 125 milligram, ferric carboxymaltose in single dose it can deliver 750 milligram, iron sucrose is 200, low molecular weight iron dextran is it can deliver up to 1500 milligram iron in single injection. IV iron therapy, there are two strategies. You can do the TDI, that is total dose infusion in single setting, and you can repeat small doses over a protected period of time. How to calculate the iron, iron needed. So it is very important. It is repeatedly asked in bypass. So total body weight of the patient multiplies by 2.3, then iron, this hemoglobin deficiency. Normal hemoglobin is 15. If patient has 10, then 15 minus 10. And 1 gram or 500 to be added for this dose. So the iron needed will be total, this body in kilo, body weight in kilogram multiplied by 2.3. multiplied by hemoglobin deficiency, and this can be infused over repeated small doses or total dose infusion can be done. Okay, the major concern with this iron preparation is anaphylaxis. Okay, so anaphylaxis is very less with the newer preparations. What we can do if you want to transfuse larger number of dose, larger dose, then you can dilute it in 5% dextrose are normal saline, then it can be infused over 60 to 90 minutes. One thing is remaining, that is the phase of iron deficiency. So you can aware of this investigations, iron profile. No? So you can go through these two slides and you can well remember what are the values. In SART we can do like in iron, negative iron balance, everything will be normal. Stores will start decreasing. In iron deficient erythropoiesis, iron values will start decreasing, and in iron deficiency anemia, the anemia will occur. Okay, then it's enough for today. Thank you so much. If any questions, you can ask me later.